we actually are scared just before our every duty that ball pit will be the situation in the casualty. Anytime anything can happen.
जब कोई आएगा तभी तो भाई भर्ती करेंगे, इसको कोई भर्ती नहीं कर रहा है इसको. अब वहाँ पड़ा हुआ था बेहोश होकर गिर गया मर गया तो क्या होगा फिर.
After Mumbai, now Delhi, doctors on strike demanding security. At least 10 more state-run hospitals joined protesting resident doctors at Deen Dayal Upadhyay Hospital. And day 8, truckers continued protests in South India but agreed to transport essential commodities. An uproar in Rajya Sabha over Alwar's cow vigilantism. Opposition blames BJP, demands thorough probe. BJP and Congress lead protests across Kerala over police's alleged manhandling of the mother of Jishnu Pranoy, a student who committed suicide. Police also detains protesters. You're watching The Big Story on Mirror now. I'm Amita Balachandra. Straight up, first Mumbai, now Delhi. Doctors from over 10 more government hospitals have joined the protesting resident doctors of Deen Dayal Upadhyay Hospital on their indefinite strike. DDU doctors went on strike on Monday, demanding more protection after alleged repeated attacks from patient skin. In fact, several hospitals, including the prestigious AIIMS, Delhi's resident doctors also have come out in solidarity with doctors of the DDU hospital.
I'm currently standing outside the office of the medical superintendent of Deen Dayal Upadhyay Hospital. No patient is being allowed inside the hospital for the reasons that doctors are not treating them and they are on strike. Even emergency cases are being shooed away saying that there are no doctors inside. The superintendent has refused to speak to us. We wanted to talk to him about the situation and take his response, but he has not spoken to us since then. This is Milan Sharma for Mirror Now.
Actually, almost 16 Delhi hospitals, government hospitals, have already joined us. Rest hospitals are still working because we don't want patients to suffer. If a pan-Delhi strike happens, then a patient is gonna get suffer. So we are concerned about a patient also.
Basic demand hamari infrastructure ko improve karna hai, security strengthen karna hai. Agar aap security nahi de pa rahe, to infrastructure ko improve kariye. Agar infrastructure aap improve nahi karte, security dijiye.
Verbal assault daily we are facing due to any reason. Maybe it can be lack of infrastructure or due to other lack of sources. But physical violence are also happening. So it is just not appreciable and not accepted.
We actually are scared just before our every duty that ball pit will be the situation in the casualty. Anytime anything can happen just because lack of the security guards, security personnel, and due to lack of infrastructure. We just want betterment of this thing from the government.
We don't have any written papers with us, and they have not released the minutes of the meeting for yesterday. So we still waiting and we still on strike right now. We don't have any options.
In fact, on The Big Story, we are joined by Dr. Sumit Parya, President, Resident Doctors Association, Deen Dayal Upadhyay Hospital, and Anil Kumar Gupta, State Office Bearer of the Delhi BJP. Welcome, both of you gentlemen, to the show. First of all, Dr. Sumit Parya, I'd like to come to you with this question. Now, we heard the doctors say, they said, of course, that anything can happen anytime and that the doctors live in fear. How true is that?
Yeah, actually, on Sunday night we had assault on the doctors and the guards there, and these are the things which we face daily. It's like every hourly we face two or three incidents, and most of the time the patients came with the, you know, saying that I know this person, I know that person. Why don't you see my patient first? You have to see my patient first, and we don't have that infrastructure with us, and which required for the patients. I feel there is lack of infrastructures which leads to all these assaults.
Also, Dr. Sumit Paria, tell me this, at this point in time, this is a problem that's existed for a while now. In 2015, there was a similar protest by resident doctors, and you'd even approached the government, and the government had assured action. So, are you saying that the government has not, lived up to its promise?
We face similar problems since last 2.5 years and many more years, but the same problems exist. The reason behind, the government gives us so many assurance, so many commitments, but they don't implement that. And this time also we want the implementation of all our demands, and we are very, very straightforward about our demands. We need infrastructure which is very much required for the patient. We want to serve patient, and we really want that the infrastructure should improve so that no patient will die or have some serious complications after that. But last few years we are demanding for security. If you do not give us this infrastructure, then why don't you give us a security? But why don't you think, I will appeal to the people of Delhi, that why don't you think that we are lack of infrastructure, that's why we are not giving you this proper treatment. And it's not our problem, it's government to see what infrastructure they would have to give for the patient's welfare. So why a doctor on duty was beaten up by the mob or by the attendant? If we don't have any infrastructure, then how will we treat you?
Right. Let me also bring in
and for
Mr.
that
Gupta.
Also we need security. If you do not give us the infrastructure, then give me the security.
Right. Let me also bring in Mr. Gupta into the conversation. Mr. Gupta, you've heard the arguments there. It's a twofold problem. You have doctors on the one hand who need security at this point in time, but on the other hand, we've heard of reports of emergency services coming to a halt there, especially in DDU. So where do you stand at this point?
See, as far as our party is concerned, BJP is concerned, we strongly condemn the attack is being done on the doctors, the paramedical staff, and on the other hand, we also see that the patient doesn't suffer. As I said, we strongly condemn. Then providing, as the Mr. Sumit has rightly said, providing infrastructure, providing facilities to the doctors and the supporting staff is primarily the duty of the state government. And I think providing the lack of infrastructure, the lack of security is the failure of the Delhi government. And the Delhi government should rectify this, should correct it, and they should have the better. Because all the government hospitals like DDU, GB Pant, GTB, all these hospitals comes under Delhi government. As far as providing services, providing security, providing infrastructure, basic amenities to the medical fraternity is the duty of the Delhi government, they should do. On the other hand, what I mean to say that as per my knowledge, there is a legal provision also which safeguard the interest of the doctors. As per the information gathered by me, there is a legislation in at least 15 states which says about the protection of the doctors, their staff from these types of problems. And what I know, recently a delegation of this IMA met our cabinet health minister Mr. Nadda ji, and Mr. Nadda ji has assured that very soon a legislation will come in the parliament which see that these types of assault on the doctors comes under criminal proceedings, and action can be taken against the rude persons, against the person who does all types of things. But now the question arises, why these types of atrocity, why these types of incident happen? It is not because we see it, doctors is a noble profession, but why these types of incidents regularly happens? Recently it has happened in DDU, some other times it has happened in GTB, some other hospital, because doctor has rightly said ki they are having a lack of infrastructure facilities. And one more thing I want to point out, the doctors are normally under pressure because there is a good number of influx. There is a lot of patients coming to this, and as compared to the number of patients, the infrastructure, the facilities, and the number of doctors are very less. And the state government should definitely do something on these things.
Dr. Sumit Paria, also tell me this. We understand, of course, now that the security is a big problem and point taken. But on the other hand, there are also patients who are, you know, suffering, patients who are not getting the kind of services that they're supposed to be getting at this point.
Look, we are fighting for the patients only. If you are fighting for security only because the government doesn't provide us the infrastructure. Infrastructure is the base of the hospital. And if you don't have that infrastructure which serves the people, then why we are serving the hospital? Look, on the other side, if a patient came to me and he asked me for the treatment, if I said I don't have a number of drugs or treatment other than these, then how will I say and how will this help to the patient?
So, Dr. Sumit Paria, now let me interrupt you there. Let me interrupt you there. Talking about patients,
we don't have the infrastructure.
Let me interrupt you there. Talking about patients, in fact, the reason we're bringing this up is because we went out and spoke to patients who are being turned away from shuttered hospitals. Listen into that.
Admit ही नहीं कर रहे भाई. हम क्या कर सकते? कह रहे कि यहाँ क्या बोले थे भाई? यहाँ पे कह रहे हैं अभी स्ट्राइक चल रही है, आप यहाँ से लेके जाओ. वहाँ से बाउंसर लेके फिर हम यहाँ पे आके बैठे हुए हैं. अब कहाँ जाए हम?
टाके लगने, वो कह रहे हैं वहाँ चले जाओ, वहाँ जा रही
है, पूरा फटा पड़ा है. टाके लगने, पता किसके पास जाए, कैसे क्या करे अब हम?
कितनी देर से आप यहाँ?
आधा घंटे से ज्यादा हो गए यहाँ बैठे बैठे.
और दादागिरी और दिखा रहे हैं,
धक्का मार के भगा रहे हैं वहाँ से गेट से.
दादागिरी और दिखा रहे हैं, देखो आप.
तो बताइए अब हम लोग करें क्या? ये देख लीजिए इसको. अब जो भी है भाई, बैठ के बात करते या भर्ती करते, फिर ही अपनी प्रॉब्लम बताता क्या है क्या नहीं है, कुछ बताएगा जब ना. जब कोई आएगा तभी तो भाई भर्ती करेंगे इसको, कोई भर्ती नहीं कर रहा इसको. अब वहाँ पड़ा हुआ था, बेहोश होकर गिर गया, मर गया तो क्या होगा फिर? वहाँ बेहोश हो गया तो अभी सारे कपड़े उपड़े सारे सने पड़े, वहाँ लेटा हुआ था अभी.
Dr. Sumit Paria, you heard patients who are in dire need of medical services there. Where should they go? What should they do now?
There is a confusion here. Actually, we said the resident doctors are on strike. It doesn't mean that all doctors are on strike. The medical officers, the consultants and the higher authorities, they are working, they are seeing the patients. And if they are not admitting the patient, if they are not seeing the patient, it's not our fault. We are the base, we know. But it doesn't mean that medical officer doesn't see the patient. They also see the patient, they can admit the patient, they can carry on the work if they want to. But the overall system is dependent upon the residents' doctors. So this system should collapse. Definitely, in other hospital, you will see the same problem. If medical officers and other consultants will not see the patient, it's not our headache. We are on strike, it doesn't mean medical officers are on strike, consultants are on strike. Let them see the patient. Why didn't they ask for the consultant to see the patients?
Right. Fair enough. You're saying that there are medical officers there, only resident doctors are on strike. However, the reason we're bringing this up on this channel is simply because we don't want it to escalate as much as it did in the state of Maharashtra, where we saw a similar thing happen. Also, let me talk about the minutes of meeting that took place today. Dr. Sumit Paria, before I go into details of what happened in the meeting, there were a number of things that were announced in terms of the security that will be beefed up. I have the document with me in my hand right now. So a number of things there about how security must be beefed up. There will be security guards at every entry point. That's what the document says. However, the one crucial thing about the document is that there are no timelines in this. Dr. Sumit Parya, respond to this.
Yeah, the minutes of meeting what we had is totally a different issue. I mean, they have given us minutes of meeting in a way that we are discussing everything, right? They have not concluded anything. They have not given us the time bound period. They have not given us other commitments. And these are these minutes of meeting, I'll give you, I'll show you 10 or 12 papers will passed. I had so many strikes I have attended. I have seen, I have 10 to 12 minutes of meeting with me, and same assurance has been given. If the assurance for the first strike is responded or concluded, this strike should not happen. Right. So these are the facts. I want this time. I want a conclusive result. I don't say I never say that they are not doing their best, but they are doing their best. But we need some propaganda. We need some concrete conclusion about it. We need some security which really effective. It's
right.
It's
when you
none,
when you talk about when you talk about that, what is the timeline you're business, looking like, at? When you talk about that, Dr. Sumit Parya, what is the timeline you're looking at?
We had a meeting yesterday, and it was concluded that we will give you provide you a security within 5 to 10 days, and we are satisfied with that. But they have not given in the papers, they have not given me in the minutes that they will provide us the security within 5 to 10 days, and we were happy that they will provide us yesterday. We were happy, and we thought that if they give me in writing, then we'll join our work. But they have not given anything like that, and with other issues also, they have not written anything
fair
about
enough,
the issues which are very
Gupta,
important
Mr.
to us.
Mr. Gupta, I want Mr. Gupta to come in here, respond to this. Dr. Sumit Parya very clearly saying that the government said that they will be given 5 to 10 days to beef up security in all of the hospitals, except that that's not been given in writing. We at Mirror Now have taken a look at the document, and there is no time-bound action there.
See, this is a complete failure of Delhi government. You know, who is the Delhi health minister? Mr. Satyendra Jain. He is the Delhi health minister, and he is also involved in a lot of illegal activities. When he is also involved in illegal activities, how much take he care of his department? There are, Sumit has rightly pointed out, it is a lack of shortage of doctors, shortage of paramedical staff, shortage of infrastructure. You know, lot of pressure is being put on the junior doctors, the resident doctors. We have a lot of influx of the patients. Patients first go to the junior doctor, resident doctor. We have a very less doctors in the hospitals. They are not appointing new doctors. They are not appointing new nurses. They are not appointing the new paramedical staff. All these things, because a doctor needs a supporting staff also. You promised to regularize these supporting staff. Now they are even withdrawing these staffs. So it is not a question of only doctors. It is a question of total infrastructure involved in the hospitals. The doctors, the paramedical, the staff, the compounders, the pharmaceuticals, all these together treat a patient. When a patient comes to the doctors, and he needs the supporting nurse, he needs the supporting pharmacist to give medicine and other things. If there is no medicine in the hospital, how a doctor will treat? If there is no facility of X-ray, CT scan in the doctors, how a doctor is going to examine? It is not a one question. Then the relative of the patient, he or she get irritated, which is not ethical, I say. When they get irritated, these types of incident happens. So I request the Delhi government to improve the infrastructure in Delhi government hospitals. All big hospitals in Delhi are with Delhi government. And I also point out, there
Mr.
are
Gupta,
few hospitals
tell me this,
which
tell me this very simply, very
there
simply.
Is one case of,
is it solely the responsible of the state government to take care of this? Shouldn't the center also sort of step in?
It is the totally responsibility of the state government. because these hospitals comes under state government. The government.
Go ahead, please.
I'm not
go
able
ahead.
To hear you.
Yeah. We can hear you, Mr. Gupta. Go ahead.
Yeah. Yeah. See, it the all these hospitals, the big hospitals in Delhi, they come from Delhi government, which is being ruled by the Kejriwal. And they are involved in their infighting. They are not taking care of Delhi. So, providing infrastructure, providing facilities to these hospitals is the responsibility of the Delhi government. And they should improve this. So, they have the total failure on these things.
Dr. Sumit Parya, very, very quickly, a couple of things that have come through in the document. Hospital chief will review security arrangements, inform a weak guards, they say, will be replaced. Adequate number of security guards will be provided. But in no sense is the document talking about how many guards will be, replaced, how many guards will made sure that they will be there in the entry points, exit points, all of those things. And by when can we expect this?
Actually, the guards which we have in the hospitals, they are retired officers from the army and some other places, and they are more than 55 or 60 years of age. And sometimes it happens when the assault on the doctor or somehow in the on between the guards and the doctors the patient attendant, we have to save the guards. So they are very inefficient and they are very weak. So we demand, if you are putting a security to us, giving security to us, at least they should protect us. The security guard should be like that. They should protect us. It is not like we are protecting our guards. So this is very important to us. And one more thing I would like to say here, there is a cadre system which should be revised, which has not been revised since 2001. Right, so we have lot of vacancies, recruitment which is required for the doctors and the staff. That also helps in the infrastructure to give support. And so that if you don't, look, I'll give you an example. In 2014, the footfall at our hospital is 2.5 lakh. It's near about 2.5 lakh. Now it's in 2016, on 31st December, when the footfall is being seen, it is 6.5 lakh, but the doctor's quantity is very less and the same, right? So these are the points where we feel lack of infrastructure, lack of recruitments, and lack of security.
Okay, Dr. Sumit Parya, we're running out of time on the show. Very quickly, Dr. Sumit Parya, very quickly tell us this. If the government does not come up with a clear time-bound action by when they will beef up security in Delhi, what are residents, doctors going to do? Will you escalate this matter further?
We are planning, and 16 other hospitals are with us, and they are also on strike. And let's see what we have sent our team to the secretariat, and we are having a meeting with the secretary again on this issue. And we'll let you know what happens after the meeting. And hopefully, I think they are very positive towards, and they will give us the security, and they will give us the time-bound period. Hopefully, they will give us.
Well, hope, of course, remains on how time-bound action will be given or not. But Dr. Sumit Parya very clearly saying that the strike is going to continue. In fact, the problem here is twofold. On one hand, the state government cannot give doctors enough security, which is a basic necessity. And on the other, there are patients who are suffering as well because of this. We cannot ignore both of these problems, which means the state government must strike a balance and provide security to these doctors. We on Mirror Now will not stop voicing this issue till that happens. With that, it's a wrap on The Big Story. Stay with us.